Welcome back, folks. Dow is up 175, Nasdaq's up 48, S&P's are up 22. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Teddy Kegstad, as we do each and every Wednesday at 40 past the hour. You can reach Teddy, folks, at every trading day at forex-trading-unlock.com. That's forex-trading-unlock.com. In fact, when Tommy and I were hunting our man Teddy this morning, you go up on the site, and they're pushing us right to the St. Peter's Power and Sailboat Show, which we actually can see out our
windows. Gotta love geolocating ads online, right? There we go. St. Petersburg Power and Sailboat Show, let alone the great site, forex-trading-unlock.com. There we go.
Hey. How's that, Teddy? We look out our window, and we can see the boat show. It's right outside. We're only a couple blocks away from the water. But that was so cool, man.
Bad thing to be looking at. It's pretty cold here in Chicago.
Oh, yeah. Well, hey, we got a lot to talk about today, man.
We have a very good day to talk about the currency. The dollar index is making some pretty big moves over the past couple of days.
Yes, yes. And how about that pound? It looks like the pound just broke topside, right?
We finally got our breakout to the upside. And, you know, I was looking for it to hit 131, you know, after like maybe a couple of sessions, but it just did it in one little shot today, you know. Yes. So very impressive move.
Yeah.
So when you get something like that, you know, I guess the pound, we get a couple weeks for the knowing what's going on over there. But when you get a continuation move like that, are you looking for like a 133, 135 in the future? Or does it just stall out for a bit? How does that normally work?
Well, normally, if it wasn't because I'm looking at the dollar index right now, I would say that I think the pound would probably take a little bit of a slower grind up towards $1.32, $1.33.
Okay.
But if you look at the dollar index in the past couple sessions, it made a higher move high, and then as of yesterday, made a lower move low, and had a really big range over a couple sessions. That's a very negative indication that the dollar is probably going to be under pressure for a couple days. And I think that might give a little more lift to the pound and you have a little more volatility. I mean, the pound, when it starts to move, if a day like today could be followed up by another day that actually moves a two full dollars easily.
Really? Yeah. Interesting. Yeah. And it's been down for so long, right? I mean, you know,
right.
Depending on how long you've, you know, basically been around, folks, the pound, you don't see the pound a lot at $1.30. Every time you go to Europe, well, every time
not
you go
recently,
to London,
at least, yeah.
You know, the bottom line is that I remember it at $1.90. I remember it at $2.10. I mean, it's like a closet over there would cost you a fortune.
Brexit's been going on for 3 years plus, yeah. So it's become a new
right.
norm, yeah.
All right.
Right. And the way it based now, you know, over the past like 2 months, you know, how it was wedging.
Yes.
I mean, it's just held solid with very tight ranges, which is not normal for the pound. And I think that with their election, I think is December 13th or 16th. I can't remember correct.
Okay.
It's one of those dates. So I was expecting it to kind of just grind higher if, you know, things were looking kind of positive for like, you know, Boris Johnson. But now I think with the dollar index under pressure like it is, and if you look at the Swiss, it did this. It looks the same as the dollar index. It made a higher move high. It looked like it wanted to really kind of hold that parity, and then all of a sudden it collapsed, you know, and made a lower move low. So that's a neutral to bearish sign for the dollar index, the Swiss. The yen, however, that's the one, I tell you guys, it's amazing how it gets beat up with the dollar initially, and then all of a sudden as the dollar is getting pounded, somehow the dollar finds strength against the yen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I don't want.
No, I know you don't want.
Hey, it is what it is, though.
That is true.
I get that. There's no doubt about that, man.
It's the one anomaly of the major currency cross rates. I mean, the New Zealand dollar looks like the British pound, too, today. I mean, it's unbelievable how high it is. So, and that's a big deal, because when you start to get your lesser majors that actually are moving that much, that volatility, that kind of a range, then no matter what, the dollar index is going to look heavy. And then currencies like the euro, which were up today and are kind of almost unchanged, you know, they
yeah.
could still rebound and make a run for the highs again if the pound stays up there.
Yes. No, I can see that. And, you know, what is intriguing, you're talking about the currencies from, you know, other smaller nations, but a lot of them are commodity countries. That hits the commodity market pretty intense. You know, like we're looking at the Aussie dollar, do you know what I mean, versus iron ore. I mean, it gets really intriguing in the context.
Right.
These countries have been used to low currency rates. And, you know, the commodity market in itself, I mean, in the long run, they're going to be 10 times better, you know, of course, if the commodities go up, because then they're all going to have strong currencies.
Definitely.
You know?
You got to watch the CRB index now.
Yes. Yeah. The variation, man, like in some of these I guess in all countries. I mean, listen, Idolo was at 70, 8 years ago? That's in 98. I mean,
huge moves, yeah.
I guess it's, you know, all currencies, right? I mean, they move quite a bit once they start moving.
They trend.
Yeah, they trend, I know.
Momentum.
So, but I think the dollar index is something to key off of. And now these rumblings, you know, the trade deal stuff is kind of always scares me because I know a lot of stuff overnight, especially in Europe, they were saying it looks like a U.S. trade deal is starting to look closer to possibly happening. That really scares me when that starts to make global news because tomorrow is the day where all of a sudden they'll say, oh, the deal's off the table again or something. You know what I mean?
No, that was yesterday, Teddy. Those women.
Yes. Right.
I agree. It's that dramatic.
Tagline was, well, what a difference a day makes, even this morning doing the updates, because it really is remarkable that yesterday it was, hold on, we got a full 11 months until the election 2020. And then this morning it was, wait, it's going to happen before December 15th, 11 days. 11 months, 11 days.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's amazing how those things swing like that, right?
Yeah, well, you know, you can see in this one fundamentally why it would happen. I mean, because those are huge taxes that everyone's paying, you know, if you're bringing stuff into the country. And if those taxes go away, it makes a big difference. Now, if those taxes don't go away on the 15th of December, there's going to be more taxes that are going to put in. And my understanding is that most of that on the December 15th is on consumer goods.
Yeah, you're talking about you know, clothing, retail, you know. $160 billion worth of goods. And that's coming into an election year to bring it in again. You know, is Trump really going to hit consumer goods as election season comes in?
Well, he's going to put a new bill in that all consumers are going to get money like all the farmers got money.
Oh, boy, here we go.
Yeah, right? How about it? Now, we do have the impeachment hearing that started today, too. So, I mean, I would be, that's something that could weigh on the dollar as well for a couple days.
Okay. And then I guess we get year-end funding. We get the repo market. The repo market, folks, what happened is that the Fed, you know, they're oversubscribed by, like, billions. They put out $15 billion first. $48 billion came in. At the end of yesterday, they went up to $25 billion. So that repo market is the banks still need more money for the end of the year. I'm surprised the Fed didn't go right to 48. It's like, okay, they're still shot $25
billion. Yeah.
And we're December 4th, so, you know, that it'd be interesting to see where that scramble comes from, you know, because I believe that the U.S. banks need dollars, you know. I mean, say they need money, but they need dollars too.
Yeah.
You know, you can't basically hold it, I believe, in other currencies as you come into that close of the year.
But, no. Yeah.
Right.
Dollars count on the balance sheet.
Yeah.
Not yen or francs or whatever you want. No. You got to put them in dollars.
Yeah.
The rebalancing is coming no matter what.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a lot coming down the line.
That's a good quote, man.
That is.
We're going to have a wild holiday market this year, guys.
I like it. Listen, folks, you can reach Teddy every trading day at forex-trading-unlock.com. That's forex. /trading-unlock.com. Teddy, you have a great one, safe one, stay warm. We look forward to speaking to you next Wednesday.
Thanks, guys.
See how
much lower the dollar is next week.
Oh,
okay.
Like it, man.
Seven
like
days.
It.
Thanks, Teddy.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I come right back.